5 Overview, Technology in the Industrial Age. So for our essential question, we have how did technology shape economic production during the period 1750 to 1900? And these two words are clues that we're looking at the effects of technology on economic production, which will make this a causation prompt. Some historical patterns, remember, as societies are connected by trade, they tend to exchange technology. So we'll see about the spread of technology here in this chapter. And also, the more efficiently you can transport goods, the more profit the merchants are making. So you might remember way back with the Indian Ocean trade route, that in the initial years of Indian Ocean trade, they tended to follow the coastline. You can see that these trade routes go right along the coast. And once they started to master the monsoons and use technology like the astrolabe, they were able to leave the coastline and travel directly across greater distances across the open ocean, and making the journey faster and increasing profits. So for context, remember, as industrialization happens, you create a demand for more goods because there are fewer people producing things on their own. And also that in the process of industrializing, we have economic competition between nations who are looking for an angle or an advantage against their rivals. So we have our specific details down here at the beginning about industrializing countries looking for new sources of profit, and an explanation about how the demand for manufactured items would increase. And then this part right down here that says this led to the development of industrial technology would be the connection sentence. And remember, I don't want to talk too much about what this is yet because I'm in the context section in which I'm introducing background information. So first we'll look at coal. Coal was used to power the steam engine, and that was a good source of power for factories. The first factories were built alongside rivers, and they were powered by moving water current. And with the steam engine, you can locate a factory away from a river. So it gives you more flexibility and allows you to boost production because you can have more factories built around your country. And this map of Britain here in red shows where the coal fields are. So these are the areas where the factories tend to be built and where industrialization and urbanization is at its height. The other advantage for coal, in addition to powering factories, is it powers steamships. This is the SS Savannah, which was the first steamship to cross the Atlantic. And that allows a ship to travel upriver or into the wind, both of which will increase trade because they can make the journey more quickly. The other thing that coal makes possible is improving iron production because it allows you to heat it up to a higher temperature. And we'll see in a coming section that that will lead to a new metal entirely. Next, we have a time period called the Second Industrial Revolution, which is in the second half of the 19th century. So the first one, remember, is roughly 1750 to 1850 or so. And then we have a whole second one that focuses more on materials like steel and oil and electricity that's more like, you know, you could say 1880 to 1950 or so. So steel is stronger than iron. It is also lighter, and it is really the backbone of industrial production. It's used for the machines, for buildings, for ships, for railroads. And so that is a major advancement in industrial technology. The other thing we have in the second industrial revolution is a new fossil fuel, which is oil. One of the advantages of oil is that it is easier to move long distances. This is a map showing oil pipelines in this reddish color right here, which means sort of like we had with the factories with the steam engine moving away from the rivers, now we can bring the fuel to the factory more easily. So in that other map of Britain, we had the factories located near the coal fields, and now factories can continue to grow and countries can build them away from the source of oil because there can be a pipeline that delivers it. It's also used in the internal combustion engine, which is an improvement on the steam engine, and that's the engine we're used to having in our cars, for instance. So that makes the second industrial revolution transportation possible, like railroads and cars. And the other advancement in the second industrial revolution is electricity, which is an easier form of lighting than oil. They used to use kerosene lamps, which was derived from oil. It also allows factories to stay open longer, and that can increase production. So one of the things we're looking for in all of these, when we talk about how technology shaped production, generally, you're looking for an increase in production. Each of these things causes profits to rise and production to increase. The next advancements we have are in transportation and in communication, which leads to the migration of people. So one of the advantages of railroads is that they're a method of moving goods and people that are not dependent on river systems. You can decide, as we see with the Transcontinental Railroad here, exactly where you want the railroad to go, and it helps to link far-flung areas like the growing cities on the West Coast all the way here to the Midwest, and then through this railroad system, you can link both coasts. So that allows you to move goods more directly and more efficiently, which boosts sales and profits. By the same token, steamships can move goods across the oceans, and one of the things we start to get is transatlantic trade that's more efficient than it used to be in the days of the sailing ships, that goods can be sent from the United States all the way to Europe and in the other direction. And the telegraph shown here is a form of instant communication that helps to coordinate business. And one thing we should focus on that the book doesn't spend a whole lot of attention on is that these transportation methods result in the migration of people as they move for work. And we mentioned in a previous section that industrialization in the United States was helped by an influx of migrant workers who came from Europe to the United States, and they tended to work in factories there. So these transportation methods are important for industrialization because they provide a workforce for the growing number of factories. So some items for our timeline. We have the first steam engine and, of course, the steamship following. The invention of steel, the first transcontinental railroad, and then the first electric power station. And you can see that the steam engine would be considered back in the first industrial revolution. And by the time we get up here to electricity, we are in the second. So we talked about those effects of technology, and the general answer that we have here is that it increased economic production. And that's categorized here in a few ways. We have new sources of power, like coal, oil, and electricity. We have new industrial materials like steel. We have the transportation of people and goods made possible by the railroads and steamships. And we have new communication tools like the telegraph and the telephone, all of which help business and production expand. And when business and production are expanding, we have profits increasing as well. That's your chapter 5.5 overview. Happy studying! Everybody learn to love each other.